Wait a minute. Update tidbit of information. Sweet. Anyway. Freaking, one Irish lady that was in love with Dutch is dead. Spoiler alert. Airstrips.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you?
About how I look.
Okay. Are you perhaps available for some work?
Debtors?
Yes.
I guess.
Your commitment to your duties is admirable. You know, Mr. Morgan, you are... Well, I'm sorry for you. No, never mind. I didn't...
Look, Strauss.
You take care.
I ain't dead yet.
No, of course not. That's what I was saying. I...
A debtor, Strauss. Who owes you money?
Well, there's a deserter from Fort Wallace. Head to him first. They're looking for him out on the road near Three Sisters. Man's name is J. John Weathers.
J. John Weathers.
Then there's a miner over in Annisburg. He's called... Well, he's called Arthur. Like you. Arthur Londonderry. Family man, desperate. You know the type.
Couldn't one of the boys do this?
I tried. They lacked your vigor.
Vigor, huh? All right.
Take care, Mr. Morgan.
You said Annisburg. That's Annisburg. J. John Weathers. Sadie Adler. Oh, we'll just go to Annisburg first. There's a camp ledger.
Susan?
Someone smashed the box.
What box?
The money box. We'd had that for so many years.
Why did they smash it?
Well, I don't know. Look at this place. All divided.
Oh, yes, I guess
everyone
that's good.
Everyone anxious and at each other's throats. I'm heartbroken.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Anyway, I won't disturb you.
Well, I suppose.
Well, that just about answered that fucking question, didn't it?
Hey, Arthur. You want to talk?
Sure. Why not?
I suppose.
You okay, Arthur?
Sure.
You don't look okay.
I'm fine.
What you been doing?
acting like a fool.
How so?
Killing and robbing folks I didn't need to.
My, you have been busy.
Well, that's one way of looking at it.
You're a good man, Arthur. Underneath, I mean.
I've lost my mind, Mary Beth. It's finally happened. I don't feel in control.
Just stay calm and do what you do best.
It seems I'm lost in mayhem. Sure, I'm no better than Micah.
Yes, you are. Just do what you gotta do and stop getting into trouble.
We'll see.
Alrighty.
So we gotta do.
So excuse me, Mary Beth.
Leave it, Bill.
And morning, Mr. Morton.
You okay?
I guess. I didn't really know Molly so well.
Molly.
Thanks for your help. Well, securing this lovely spot.
What's her name?
To carve a country from man's desire and not some old world juju. Wasn't that a beautiful fantasia, Arthur?
If you say so, Dutch.
Can I antagonize
Dutch? Such a beautiful
Dutch?
Dream. I can hardly keep focused. So poorly rendered.
Nope, can't antagonize Dutch. Alright. One of these days I will. I'll antagonize him. I'll antagonize him.
Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
All right, Pearson. Looking pretty well stocked now.
Good job, Mr. Morgan. Very into my crafting at the moment, Mr. Morgan. I'm very happy to make you something if you bring me the right materials.
I don't even know where to find
Thanks,
that
Mr.
Crap.
Pearson. You okay, boy?
I can't believe that bitch ratted on us.
If she was even telling the truth, the girl was crazy. Well, I should get back to it.
Sure, Arthur.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stay here for a while.
Do you like an issue?
Thanks.
Well, for the next one. All you need to know in the new Hanover Gazette. Mr. Morgan.
You still here, kid?
Yes. Mama. Mama can't leave. Or won't leave. I don't know. I said I had the money. She said your money weren't moral. She said it'd be better to die than to take it.
Maybe she's right. I don't know. I don't know anything about morals.
She's still heading out. Working, you know?
I'm sorry, son. Sorry about all of this.
She ain't been back for a few hours. She left with some fella down the railway tracks. I did not like the look of him.
Which way, you say?
That way. Around the woods, towards, Willard's Rest.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
Okay, there. Yep. That's enough now, partner. You're starting to scare me, let alone the poor woman. Clear off.
Who are you?
Someone who don't want to hear no more of your nasty mouth. Push me. I'll put a bullet in you.
I presume Archie sent you?
I said clear off before I deal with you.
I'll see you again, dearie.
Listen. Listen to me. Excuse me.
You sound like my husband.
I know. Listen, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what happened. I was a fool. And I'm suffering for my foolishness. But don't go and get yourself killed because of your pride. You have a son. Mrs. Downs.
I'm just so ashamed.
Ashamed? Of what? You loved him? You did everything for him? Let's get you home.
All right. Let's go.
sorry it had to come to this.
Stop saying sorry. Sorry won't bring Thomas back.
I know.
So you're sick now too? And you think that affords you the opportunity for penance for cutting his time short?
No. I ain't looking for that.
Okay then. So just forget about me and the guilt you're carrying, because no good can come of that for either of us. And all you can do now is decide the man you want to be for the time you have left. Help someone who can still be helped. Why help yourself?
I suppose you're right.
Oh, hang yourself for all I care.
You're right to dislike me. I ain't looking for that to change. Archie should be waiting for us just up ahead.
You got a problem, friend?
Hello, sir.
This fog is making me crazy.
Mama! Mama!
Oh, you silly boy. Oh, Archie, what do we do?
Get out of here. Go. Live someplace else. Start over. Here. Take this. I don't need it no more.
I don't want your money.
Yeah, I know you don't want it.
I don't.
You sure as shit need it. Take it.
No.
I ain't looking for forgiveness. It ain't about that. But don't forgive me. Just take the money and get out of here. Please. I know I ruined your life. I suffer for it every day. But don't let yourself get killed for pride. I seen it kill too many folk. Don't say anything. Don't thank me. Just take the money and pack your bags. That's all I gotta say.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
I said don't thank me. Get out of here. Please.
Must be your first time.
Let's have a look in here.
That is a real favorite around here. I can answer any question you may have. I hear there was a big shootout with the Murphy gang in the caves at Beaver Hollow.
Oh, I gotta come back to this guy more often.
please. I can't feel my leg anymore. You have to get this strap off me, please. Keep pulling. I could feel it getting loose. Oh, God. Oh, oh, you did it. Oh, oh. I gotta get some scrap or something here. Oh, oh, mister, you. I thought I was gonna be. Oh, no! Oh, I thought I was gonna be a goner. Oh, you can take whatever you want from my pack for saving me. Oh.
Here, this'll help with the pain at least.
Oh, oh, yeah. Yes. Yes. Oh. 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 They have a field day over this bit.
Why did you go that direction anyway? Thank you.
Whoa.
You're all right, boy. Hold on.
Hold your horses.
J. John Weathers.
They call me Snow Goose now.
Whatever they call you. You borrowed money off of Leopold Strauss. The bills come due.
This ain't the best time, sir.
This ain't the best time for anyone.
Mr. Strauss knew it was a long-term proposition.
The debt is due.
Okay. I got supplies meant to last through the winter. Is there any way you can help me? I stay out here, there won't be anyone to pay you.
I ain't here to help. I'm here to collect. We're all of us up against it.
Look, there's men after me. They're killers. I ain't a deserter, just an objector. It ain't right. If there was another way than running, I need your help.
Shut up.
Please.
Up here, it's him.
It's right. I clear off, sir.
Shit! Well, seeing as I'm here, I'll do what I can for you.
It's all right, my darling. You can come out.
Oh, crap. I probably should have helped you fix the damn wagon.
We could probably still save something.
Really now?
Look, you can take the silver locket for the debt.
Fine. Now, go. Get her somewhere safe. Go on.
Thank you, feller. I don't know where we can go, but I'll try. Pray for us.
We're past praying, boy.
That's super unfortunate.
Easy.
Can you help? Can you help me, mister?
What's the problem?
My goddamn horse got spooked and run off.
You hurt?
Not too bad, at least. But he took my damn leg.
Sorry.
His name's Buell.
Buell?
Second time a prick named Buell cost me a leg.
Huh?
Buell was my general when I lost it.
Okay.
Anyway, if you see an angry bastard of a horse with my wooden leg, I'd be real grateful.
I'll bear that in mind. This way. Come on. Now come on, then. Let's get you back. He's just where you left him. Can't go far with that leg in your stirrup. Can't go bucking him like that. So you better be good, you hear? I get the notion he's not a man you want to cross. No matter how big and strong you are. Spook you here. Come on. You're not so nasty. I found him.
You're a good man, Mr. Mr.
Arthur. You're right. He's a brute.
Hamish Sinclair. Yeah, he's a great horse. I saw it from when the devil got him. Hey, you want to hand me that leg there, please? And while you're at it, give old Buell a kick for me, would you?
No, I'm only kidding.
Thank you. Weren't but a snake that spooked him. You're a real gentleman, you know?
Sometimes, maybe. Yeah, how'd you lose a leg?
Oh, in the war. Cannonball. Pretty clean, though. I don't have much pain, and I didn't get any gangrene. A young boy went into battle with me. Got cut in half, so all things considered, I'm doing pretty well, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. So, how is the false one?
It's okay. I can still hunt, fish, enjoy the outside. Weren't sent too crazy by it. Anyway, I think I must have picked you with.
You know, that's okay.
You like fishing? You come with me someday. I know some pretty good spots.
I'm a pretty poor fisherman.
Yeah, well, I'm great. So between the two of us, we do okay. My cabin is right over on the other side of O'Cray's Run there. Thanks again. You throw me again, you old dumb bastard. I'm gonna put a bullet in you. I'll see you again.
I like him. Don't get attached, though. I know that was gonna happen.
Easy, man. Easy.
Just give me a minute, boy.
Business at the mines?
I'm looking for an Arthur Londonderry. I was told he works here.
Londonderry? Oh, you'll want to speak to the foreman. He's down in the pit.
Arthur Londonderry. Is she here?
I'm sorry, feller, but you're too late. Arthur's dead.
The man's dead. What's wrong with you?
Oh, boy. You can't exactly beat it out of him now, can you? You might get something off his widow just across from Butcher's Creek, but I'd hurry. you ain't gonna be the only one a-knockin'.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Hey, I ain't the godforsaken moneylender.
Hey, Mr.
Whoa, whoa.
Just calm down. Time to go, boy.
Hey, partner.
I can't see a damn thing.
That's fire. Mind if I warm my bones? Y'all knew these was Murphree Hills. You should be careful where you're camping.
I can look after myself. Besides, it's a free country.
Free country? No. Everything bought and paid for. And we're gonna protect what's ours. Y'all be careful where you wander. Come on, let's go. I think you got the message.
Go kill you next time.
Business.
Okay, boy. Shh. Easy now. Good boy.
Barclay, come on. I think that last encounter was to show you that if you're gonna be a dick, don't. Yeah, I know. Ooh, dead body.
Easy there. Good boy.
Howdy.
Ridge, it's 631, 57 degrees. You're gonna go out there, shoot somebody. Camp.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Easy, whoa.
Ah, damn it. Perfect rabbit belt.
Hey, boy. Yep. Okay. There we go.
I don't know what you did. Well, if I already caught the... What is it like? It's a river. No.
Let's try something new.
Whoa. It's a small one.
Some legendary fish, am I right?
Off you go then.
This one. Tiny one.
I'm gonna fucking use all my cricket bait before I have a chance to fucking.
You can go. Maybe. Fight it.
I know elk is a big creature. I'll go turn all this in.
Yep. Okay, boy. Okay. Wait.
Thank you.
at all these tiny bluegills. Oh my god.
Off you go then.
Run out of fucking bait.
Okay.
Dude, I'm about to shoot you in the goddamn face. No one is that happy doing whatever it is you're doing. Oh, that looks unnatural. Okay. Ran out of fucking.
You can go.
Out of bait. I want to be a masturbator.
I got you.
Nope. Small one.
Ah, you'll do. You're in luck, my friend.
Even if I caught him, I don't think I had the horse to put him on.
Throw it up.
If you're looking for gold, I'd go upriver. I'm having no luck here.
Yeah, but I'm gonna shoot you because you're fucking annoying.
Thank you.
Where am I going? Oh, I ran past my fucking objective.
So up now. Yeah.
How you feeling, ma'am?
Much better than I felt in a long time. If we hadn't caught that rabbit, I don't think I made it another day.
Well, you look better.
Better and determined, thanks to you. And if I'm gonna learn to hunt, I figured it was time I learned how to use Cal's gun properly.
Well, how's that working out for you?
Well, let's just say my prey is looking decidedly unscathed. At the end of labor, it's to gain leisure. Is that not what Aristotle said?
Well, I don't know much about Aristotle, but I know a thing or two about shooting a gun. Look, you gotta hold steady and firm. You just focus, breathe slowly, and always pull the trigger on empty lungs. Here, I'll show you. Okay, calm and steady. Snatch at the trigger.
You make it look so easy.
All right, you try now. Remember to breathe.
Wait to breathe out. Wait to breathe out.
Anticipated.
Would you look at that? I haven't hit one that close all day.
Not bad. Focus on the inhale. Shoot on the exhale. My turn. I'll shoot a few more this time.
Oh no, that wretched rat is back. Over there, you see? It's been a thorn on my side ever since we moved here. Kill it, please.
I don't see it.
I told you it was fast. Anyway, my turn. Come on, come on. Yes! I hit it! I hit it, didn't I? What can I say? Thank you. I still have some of the rabbit left that I salted up. Would you join me for a meal? It's the least I can do. Go ahead and take a seat at the table. Food is just about done. Oh. Well, it's good and hot. I hope you enjoy it. You helped me to catch it, after all. Bon appetit.
Huh?
Please enjoy. And thank you again for everything. I really am grateful.
It was nothing.
You're a good man.
Oh, you don't really know me.
I know enough. There's always more to find in ourselves. You helped me to see that. My husband, Cal, was such an optimist. I found that very contagious. But there's a fine line between optimism and naivete. We were both born with a silver spoon. Banquets, butlers, valets.
Sounds terrible.
It's just so many people, so many things. I was lost in it. I was crushed by it. My father was very overbearing. Then we came out here and I got crushed by this. You know, I pictured myself picking fresh vegetables, sipping homemade wine, writing a great novel. But I turned out to be a far more pathetic anti-heroine than any I could ever pen.
Oh, well. I reckon you're gonna be just fine.
Are you all right? Can I get you some water?
No, I'm fine. I just, thank you for this. I think it's best if I make...
Stay right there. It's gonna be okay. My dear Arthur, I have gone out hunting. Not a phrase I thought any pen of mine would ever ink, but nonetheless one I am very proud to finally be able to write. I am so very grateful to you for all the help and encouragement you've given me. There is some money in a box on the nightstand. Please take it. I have far more than I need back in the city, and I'd like you to have it. Please take care, and remain true to the man I know you are.
I guess we'll go home first. Send all this in. You know, I could always rely on you.
Okay, fella.
The other horses, not so much.
Yeah.
We're on our way.
Let's go, boy.
Damn it. Starving.
Come on, pal. Yeah.
Who goes there?
It's me, Arthur.
Hope you had a good old time while I've been stuck standing here.
Many thanks. Thank you, Arthur. I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things around here if you want to take a look. Remember, you won't find something like this anywhere else.
I did all that fucking hunting for practically nothing.
Ah, yes, that'll be much appreciated.
Well, a few changes never hurt.
I don't care what the story is, ladies, you're going in.
Yeah.
Please! Get me out of this damn...
Hello, mister.
Please, tell me you've seen Gavin.
I don't even know what he looks like.
Big bloke. Cockney. Londoner. Hilarious. Oh.
How'd you make it all the way from fucking Saint Denis?
No, sorry.
The roads.
I've yet to meet any hilarious Londoners.
Oh, he's the best. Gavin! I am so worried.
Time to go, boy.
Gav! 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 Where are you? Where are you? I mean, nobody's seen hide nor hair of him. Gavin!
Yeah. Easy. Whoa.
pack all your stuff, Angel?
I don't wanna go.
It'll be an adventure.
I don't want adventure. I want my.
Mrs. Londonderry.
Hoth is dead.
I know. I'm sorry for it. It's just. We lent Arthur some money, you see, and.
So it was you. You son of a bitch. What do you want now? You want my boy's shoes? You want the food out of our bellies? What little there is? You want me to lie down for you?
No, no.
Arthur gave everything to pay your bills. Everything. And now there's some fellas coming to take the house. There ain't nothing left, mister.
I just wanted to say the debt's canceled and to take this. It won't bring your husband back, I know. You need money and I don't.
Well, you're a good man. I just wish you'd done it before he worked himself into the grave. But you know, maybe you and your friend that lent him the money could do things differently. Like, not threaten a man. Excuse me.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I really am.
My glasses are starting to hurt my ears.
Things are gonna be okay, Jack.
Can I go play in the cave?
Ah, how did you get on, Mr. Morgan?
Just dandy. Hmm. Just get up.
What?
Get up!
What is wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Nothing at all.
What are you doing?
Something I should have done a long time ago. Get your bag. Is this it?
I don't understand.
I ain't gonna kill you, though I probably should. You disgust me. And you shame us. If we could be shamed any more than we already are, that should do. Go!
I don't understand you. What are you doing?
Go and get a job!
You know, they say the sick delude themselves. I was your friend.
You and me, we ain't decent. But those folk, they was. Now here, take that. Take that and get lost.
I'm
leaving.
So you think Dutch has lost his mind, Arthur?
I don't know anymore. I'm not sure I even care.
Well, Micah says you've been saying crazy things about him.
Micah. Keep an eye out for Micah, Bill. He says a whole lot. All right, well, I should be getting on.
All right.
You all right?
Are you all right? Strauss is gone.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
All right, then.
Glad to be home?
I almost wish we were back in Guarma.
I know.
All right, let me see. Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
What is that logo?
In time. Oh, you're a good man. A good man.
Just had to ask for help, huh?
Nice to see you again, sir.
If you wouldn't mind coughing in your sleeve, sir, I really can't afford to get sick again this month.
Why don't you just do your job?
Be seeing you. Ladies and gentlemen, the train is a hair behind schedule.
Alright, pending any more stranger tasks, let's go save John Marston.
How's it going?
Come on, Bertram, please!
No! Bertram, say no!
Everything okay?
Imagine saving people. Girl. Taking them to your breast, metaphorically, I mean. Like a mother, caring and raising them. And then they go and stab you in the back. Have you ever betrayed a close friend? I hope not.
Well,
treachery! And these are sad, low, unlovable people, and I made them stars, dreamers, entertainers, and they... Oh, no, now family's not enough. No, no, he's gone off alone. My little tiny magician has gone and stabbed his mom on the back. Oh, fuckity! No! Bertram! 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 Woof, woof! Bertram! Put the nice man down! Do something! You'll eat him!
Easy there. Easy there! Sherry!
Bertram!
Easy, big guy.
Mean!
Let's make...
Bertram got a warp sale.
Listen to your mother.
Come here, Bertram.
Oh, really
yes,
awful
Marjorie's here. No one's gonna hurt you ever again.
Mama, you should keep that thing in a cage.
You should think about who you're serving. Give me a beer, will you?
Don't worry, we'll pay for what we broke. Come here, Bertram. Oh, no one looks after you like Mama does. No one cares for you like I do. Especially not that Magnifico. Hmm?
But he's my friend.
Yes, well, if he were your friend, he'd be here, wouldn't he? He wouldn't have abandoned us. Oh, you wouldn't have gotten that whoopsie, would you?
Whoopsie heart.
I know. Mama's gonna make it all better. But first you gotta tell me where that little worm ran off to, hmm?
Bertram promised.
Yes, well, Magnifico made a promise too, huh? He made more than a promise. He made a contract and he broke it. So you just tell me exactly where he is and then we will all be even. That's my boy.
Mickey's camping in the woods.
Why didn't you tell me in the first place? You just apologize to these men.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You gave me a whoopsie.
Hey, you just stay away from that sherry now, you hear?
Bertram likes sherry.
Oh, don't you get him started. Thank you for all of your help, Mr. Stranger.
If you see that slippery little fella sleeping rough out there, would you just make a little racket and then we'll come along and we'll find you?
I could try.
Oh, his name is Magnifico. You'll know him when you see him. Come along, Bertram.
Why is everything moving?
Shit. I never thought nobody would catch me with that fat lady.
My limbs don't work right.
With me, boy.
Yeah. Oh, hopefully it'll be back in on the way. Be such a snob about it.
You're one of the good ones, ain't you? Thank the Lord for that. Will you get me out of here? Will you get me away from these men?
You'll be all right, ma'am. Bad men are taken care of.
Hope you're right, sir. I'm grateful for your help as far as it went. What did I do? Oh, you bastard!
Okay, fella.
Insist.
Insist all you like. Ain't happening. Arthur Taylor.
Taylor what?
She ain't coming with us to collect her husband.
Abigail, you ain't coming. That's the end of the matter.
See, there you heard him. Now let's go.
But
nothing. It'll be quicker and easier with just the two of us. Plus, John will be calmer without worrying about you. Ain't complicated.
Well, I ain't the crying sort, but I'm real grateful.
Yeah, we know you are. We'll bring him back to you.
Thank you. Thank you both.
Just go back and wait for the next game.
We'll land the boat in the morning when the prisoners come back out to work the fields. The place is surrounded by marshland. Should hopefully give us a bit of cover to move in close enough to find a spot. Look for John.
Then all we gotta do is take out all the guards and row our way out of there. Seems simple enough.
How many times, Marston?
Okay, bring us over. We good? Let's head for that watchtower.
Okay.
Stay low.
Hey, I think I see him. There's a group in front of that barn just to our right.
Yeah. I see two guards. Okay, take them out and let's go get our boy.
Okay.
Seriously?
Will you hurry up?
Will you shut up? Gonna have tuberculosis if you don't recall.
Come on, Arthur. Let's keep moving.
Where is he? You see him?
No. You. Mister. You know John Marsden?
He ain't working today. Put the gun down, lady.
No.
Did you not see me?
You put the gun down. Now. Where's John Marston?
He ain't in the work detail today.
Okay, well, I guess we'll go and get him together. Try anything, I'll blow your damn head off. You clear on that?
Yes. Very clear.
Oh, no, you don't.
Come on, partner. Why don't you apologize to the lady for pointing a gun at her?
Excuse me?
I said apologize.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Ain't no harm done.
So, where do we go?
Towards the entrance, I guess.
And who's in charge of this fine establishment?
Jameson, sir.
Jameson who?
No, Mr. Jameson. Heston Jameson.
Is he a nice fella?
He's been quite an exacting boss at times.
I look forward to meeting him.
There
They're not gonna let you do this.
Well, that's gonna be up to you, my friend.
Oh, God.
So, you a popular employee, my friend?
Not especially.
Well, I guess we're about to find out.
Sorry, I thought this was going to be exciting. I'm not moving any faster than this, and I can't.
You better hope someone in there actually gives a damn about this fool.
Guess we'll see. We're going to have to shoot our way out of here regardless.
Hold your fire!
Stay down!
Shit.
Okay, fam, be cool now. Just do as I say.
Put the weapons down, now!
Jameson! Is Jameson in?
He's in South Denis.
They got Milliken. Got him and gonna kill him. Unless you bring me John Marston. Right now. You got 1 minute. I'm counting. One, two, three.
Milliken, is it?
Yes, sir.
Will you count for me? I got talking to do.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. From one or four?
Oh,
sir?
Very funny. No, we must be at 11 by now.
11, 12, 13.
Faster.
14, 15, 16,
17. Now hurry up. 18, 18. Well, this poor fool's gonna get his brain shot out. And over what? For nothing. Hey, Milliken, don't stop counting. I can't hear you.
Hurry up and bring that asshole out here, you bastards. Come on.
Don't cry, buddy.
I don't want to die.
Yeah, I know. Hey, John, will you too?
Now, no funny business. Or Mr. Milliken here will stop crying once and for all.
Okay, today's your lucky day. Let's go!
Let's clear these and make a run for it!
That the vital spot is in place.
place seems to need rescuing, Marshal.
Nice to see you, Arthur.
There's some fellas coming here. Don't look too friendly. We best get out of here.
Come on, boys. Let's move. I'll roll. You shoot.
Seriously?
Let me. You're a better shot.
Right, fine. You just relax and enjoy yourself, John. Leave the real work to them as can still handle it.
Thanks.
Keep them off us.
John, you're not in a position to taunt.
You know, I think I liked you better when you was all trussed up like a prized chicken.
No doubt.
Well, hurry up! They're gonna be on our tail soon enough if you boys keep wasting time.
Oh, that's us told, Dan.
Hey, Arthur. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Let's go. We should get out of here quick before the law gets wind of this. Yeah.
So what the hell happened in Saint Denis? Is Abigail all right?
She's fine. Jack is too. She managed to escape when they got Hosea.
Hosea? That still don't seem real somehow. All them years. Arthur. He was like family.
Yeah, we lost young Lenny, too.
No. What a goddamn mess. And then we... What about the money?
Lost somewhere at the bottom of the ocean.
What? How the hell did that happen?
We hit on a boat. The only way out of there. The boat went down in a storm, and we ended up stranded on an island somewhere near Cuba.
Cuba? Wait, you're gonna have to tell me all this again.
It's a long story, but things ain't been good, John.
You're telling me?
We're holed up now in the mountains to the north, near Roanoke Ridge, some caves there. The Pinkertons caught up with us again, and we had to move.
Yeah, seems Molly ratted us out, the bitch. So she's dead, too.
Jesus! Maybe you should have just left me to hang.
And, I should warn you, Dutch didn't want us breaking you out. Said it wasn't the right time, so... Might not be the hero's welcome you're imagining.
So much for no man left behind. I can't stop thinking about this. In the bank, when they grabbed me, he saw it. Felt almost like he had a moment to do something and didn't.
Dutch ain't himself right now. Or maybe he just ain't who we thought he was.
Guess we don't need to worry about who's his favorite no more.
Yes, not.
We told you we would.
John! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you what? Too, partner.
I meant I hadn't sent for you yet.
I went.
But I said that.
Yeah, I know what you said. I felt different.
Is that so?
Yes.
And when Spring and John brings the law down on all of us, what then, Arthur?
Well, I guess we'll have another fight on our hands.
Loyalty, Arthur, it ain't. I had a goddamn plan! John, you are my brother. You are my son. I was coming for you.
That... They was talking of hanging me, Dutch.
They was talking. They was talking. And now they may come and hang us all.
Smoke break.
Arthur! Arthur!
Oh, sorry. I was miles away, thinking of, I don't know.
Dutch said to tell you he and Mike have gone to Annisburg. Something about Mr. Cornwall.
Cornwall. Thanks, Mary Beth.
Great. My God.
Arthur. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, he ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems...
to have lost his mind? I know.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
Not exactly a welcome home party.
What's with you?
Are you gonna throw me out like Strauss?
Maybe, if it comes to it. Well, I should get back to it.
Okay, Arthur.
Oh, Mr. Morgan! I've jotted down a few things that I think could be, nice additions around here.
Just seems like we're making a whole lot of trouble. No real reason.
Making trouble for those who deserve it always seemed reason enough for Dutch. Problem is, I ain't sure he cares who he's fighting no more.
Can't kill everyone.